Hi, it's God here. I'm your narrator for tonight's show. Yes, that's right, God. Yahweh. Allah. Whatever you want to call me, I'm it. God exists. How about that? But before you believers in the audience start high-fiving, sorry, but you were wrong too. Yes, God exists, but you were wrong about the merciful bit. You see, I'm evil. That's right. God is evil. Satan? Ah, he's just my little PR guy. You know, like Tony Abbott used to be John Houston's press secretary. I'm the evil one. And here I was thinking I made it obvious. You want proof that I'm evil? Okay, well, I created you. How's that? If that isn't enough, think about this. There is no pattern, no purpose, no everything happens for a reason. You do good things, you get motor neuron disease. You do bad things, you get motor neuron disease. And if you don't get motor neuron, there's floods, bushfires, cot death, AIDS, suicide bombers, and this. See? Now, you're probably wondering what happens to you when you die and go to heaven. Well, see, what happens is I eat you. Believers, non-believers, I eat them all. Yummy! Thanks to MasterChef, I use a lot of creative flavours. But my fave on the menu is always the believers. The look on their face when I start feasting on their entrails. I crack myself up sometimes. There's all these people out there doing my work, giving gay people aversion therapy, blowing up children at the Boston Marathon, doing acts of mercilessness because they believe in a merciful God. And then they get to heaven and find out, I'm not merciful. It's almost a shame to eat them. Anyway, where was I? Oh yes, the show I'm narrating tonight is called Modern Unconsciousness. No one knows what that means, least of all the people I'm about to introduce. So without further ado, I'll get out of the way and hand over to the stars of tonight's show, the band who would be as evil as me if they weren't so shithouse. Ladies and gentlemen, the DC3. G'day, God here again. How's it going so far? Is this bullshit making any sense? Look, you still have time to leave, and because it's the Fringe Festival, you can probably catch a one-woman show about her awakening sexuality in the Provence region. Sorry, it's God here again. I thought I'd better butt in here, because you're probably scratching your head and going, what the fuck's Invisible Gorilla? It was this famous experiment. Subjects watch a video of a basketball match, and they're told to count the number of passes the basketballers make. So they count the passes, and they don't notice some fuckwit in a gorilla suit who walks into the shot and starts waving. See? He's the invisible gorilla, the really obvious thing that you don't notice because you're too busy with the fine detail. Like, say, the fact that even though you've got the latest iPhone app, one day you'll die and be eaten by a merciless god.
That's A-N-A-K-K-I-A-N-A-K-I. I'm into anarchy. It's just posture wrong. Well, life is nice and orderly, and folks just get along. Anarchy. I'm into anarchy. I like the sound of it. I put my hammock on a tree and laze around on it. I'm into anarchy. I'll buy myself a little land and live nice and ordinary, where things all go as planned. Anarchy. Johnny Rotten in those lawless days of anti-establishment. He wanted anarchy for the UK. I think I know now just what he meant. I'm into anarchy. I paint a big A on my face. It stands for amity and all things in the place.
Hang on a minute, you blokes. Your audience has probably got no idea what you mean by groovy toilet. Sorry, everyone. Let me explain. Have you ever been to some snooty, upmarket bar or restaurant and you want to go and have a wee, only the toilet area has no markings or door handles, just some fucking uber-subtle architectural mise-en-scene, so you don't know if you're going to walk into the ladies or the men's? And then when you do get in there, the urinals are in a circle, so you have to look at some other bloke in the eye while the two of you are taking a piss. That's what they mean by a groovy toilet. But what it really means is you've paid good money, you've tried to keep up with the story so far, you've endured all this faux intellectual bullshit, and what do you get at the end of it all? A fucking toilet joke. I ought to hire these guys. They are evil.
Yeah. always said at night, you know there'll come a point in your life where you give it all up and get a day job.